Hey guys, today we're going to learn how to add Shadcn UI to an Astro project. So if you're using Astro and you want to get some cool UI components like these, I'll show you how to do it. We're going to need React and Tailwind to get started, but let's get started with the documentation and get set up. So I'll name the directory Shadcn UI Astro. So yeah, we're going to need to install React. This is a collection of reusable components in React, so we'll have to run through that. But we can do it really quick. It's pretty simple. There's actually a whole page. I can link this page below if you're interested in seeing the documentation, but let's just run through it really quick. All right, we're going to say yes to sample files, yes to dependencies, yes to TypeScript. We will use strict and yes to a Git repository. Let's CD into the project and we will run code dot to launch VS Code. All right, so we need to add both React and Tailwind to this Astro project. So I'm in my directory. I'll run npx astro add react. All right, that's done. And let's do npx astro add Tailwind. So these are both requirements, React and Tailwind. You need these installed in your project. All right. And I'm going to just use all the default options for these. And then we need to go into our tsconfig Tailwind. And inside of compiler options, we need to put in some code for the base URL as a period, the path as @*, and then the path is ./source/*. This is just telling the tsconfig some of the paths and some of the locations of the things. Then we need to initialize the project. We're going to say yes to proceed. We'll say yes to TypeScript. We're going to say default. So here you can actually pick your color. You can actually pick your color in this menu here. Let's try stone. Do the default option for the global CSS. CSS variables, yes. Tailwind config. So it's asking us where our Tailwind config is located. It is indeed in the root of the project. We'll say @components is fine. We'll say @lib_utilities is fine. Are we using React server components? No. We'll say yes to components.json. Okay, we're almost done. We have to import the global CSS. I'm going to do that in the layout since all of my pages are going to use layout. I will import @styles-global.css. Okay, so we're almost done. We need to go to the astro.config.mjs file and we will make this into within the Tailwind function, we will add a property for apply base styles equals false. And I think that's it. So let's try and add a button. So a button is a very commonly used component. Go into our terminal here and add npx shadci-un @latest_add_button. And you'll see here within our components directory, so source components UI, we have the button.tsx. So let's go to our index page and we will import button. We'll import button from @-components-ui-button. Within main here, we will set it to button hello world. And then let's run npn run dev to ensure that that is rendering correctly. So one area where I ran into some issues is adding the global CSS. So previously, before I manually added it, it was throwing errors. And I don't know if it's because the init process didn't add it correctly, but I did have to go through and manually add a directory called styles and then manually add a CSS file called global CSS. And then it just imports basically their variables. I can link this document below. This is just the global variables for this site. But you can see now if we run npm run dev, we get the Shadcn UI button. You're going to have to build these components with React in mind. If you're unsure of React and working with React, I do plan on doing more React videos in the future. So make sure you're subscribed down below. But this is a good starting point, I thought, to show you how to import this collection of UI components. So look, here's a nice little input box with a placeholder text. And here's a button. So yeah, this is enough to get you started. I hope this was helpful. Give me a like if it was. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.